Hello everyone, this is Dr. Hemant Chandak, and you all know that we will be covering few aspects of our curriculum in online mode, and as I discussed in our earlier meeting, I will be covering the two units which are specifically dealing with the physical chemistry. One of them is photochemistry and the second one is the molecular spectroscopy. In both these units, we will try to understand the fundamental principles and the phenomena that governs the nature. And in this unit number 5, in our today's talk, we will first of all have a look at the content of our year syllabus, and thereafter we will have a look at the few important and introductory topics related to the photochemistry. Let me begin with the content. The content of your syllabus are like this. There are roughly nine broad topics which we need to cover. And of these, first thing first is we will understand what is photochemical reaction, and then we will compare it with how do they differ from the thermal reaction. We'll also see the laws of absorption of light with a special reference to the Lambert's law and the Beer's law. Thereafter, we'll see laws of photochemistry. And there are two laws of photochemistry. One of them is Grotthus-Dreper and the second one is Stark-Einstein law. We'll cover these two laws. Thereafter, we'll see quantum yield. We'll try to understand how one can express the quantum yield of a photochemical reaction. We can also find out the reasons for high and low quantum yield. We'll also look for the experimental determination of the quantum yield. Thereafter, we'll go for the photosensitized reaction. Kinetics of the photochemical decomposition of HI. Then we'll see some luminescence phenomena like fluorescence, phosphorescence, chemiluminescence, bioluminescence, and we'll try to understand the phenomena of fluorescence and phosphorescence with the help of Jablonski diagram. And we will also try to solve few numericals based on the concepts and the principles that we learn in this unit. So essentially, moving forward, the first thing first is we'll try to understand what is photochemistry and what is photochemical reaction. So photochemistry essentially is the branch of chemistry that deals with the reaction caused by absorption of light from UV or visible region. And it is needless to mention that the UV and the visible region, it ranges from 200 nanometer to 800 nanometer. The word photochemistry itself tells us that it is something which is a combination of photon and the chemicals. So essentially, we will try to understand how do the photon interact with the matter and how it leads to the chemical reaction. So it is essentially the branch of the chemistry that deals with the processes involving the absorption or emission of light. I have deliberately added the word emission here because absorption I talked earlier. Emission is essentially because we know that there are many chemical reactions that produces light, and one of the famous example of we know firefly, it produces light, isn't it? And it is an outcome of the reaction between reaction because of the enzyme luciferase and the protein luciferin. So we will try to understand a few interesting phenomena, and the question that should strike to one's mind is why only UV and visible? Because electromagnetic spectrum is a way long from radio wave to the gamma ray. So out of that, only UV and visible is responsible for the photochemical reaction. Why not other regions are responsible? If a material absorb microwave, or if a material absorb, or if a chemical absorb the radio wave, why it cannot produce the reaction? The simple reason is, in chemical reaction, we involve bond breaking and bond making. And these bond breaking and bond making are essentially related to the bond energies of the molecule. And the energy of the bond energies of the molecule, they are falling close to the energy of radiation falling in the UV and visible region. And that is why only UV and visible region, they are responsible for bringing about the photochemical change. On the contrary, if you have something like radio wave or microwave or infrared, which are low in energy, they are not sufficient to bring about the breaking and making of the bond. And on the contrary, the other side of the electromagnetic spectrum where we have gamma rays, these gamma rays are not, they are so powerful that they will reach up to the nucleus of an atom and they will bring about the change in the nuclear configuration. We will have a look at this particular topic in more detail when we look for the unit number 6, that is molecular spectroscopy. So with this background, we'll move forward and we'll try to define what is photochemical reaction. So I hope the things are clear. The word is very simple, photo and chemistry. So you need to have some juncture between the photon and the chemical. And there should be some reaction taking place, which is because of the absorption of light, or there must be some reaction that should produce light. So this is what the basic essence of photochemistry is. Now, let us understand what is photochemical reaction. The reaction which is caused by the absorption of UV or visible light is called as photochemical reaction. And photochemical reactions are not new. And we all know that the very fundamental phenomena of life is photosynthesis. And in photosynthesis, what happens? Carbon dioxide and water, they are converted into carbohydrate using light and chlorophyll as a photosensitizer. So chlorophyll is a photosensitizer that absorbs the radiant energy from the light and transform it to the reactant molecules, which are CO2 and water, and converts it into sugar and oxygen. So you may be aware about the Kelvin cycle in the photosynthesis. So these are all this picture clearly tells you about the chemistry of photosynthesis. And not only photosynthesis, there are many phenomena in nature which are occurring in our daily life which are involving the photochemical reaction. If you remember those earlier days camera, where we had a negative film and we used to use those Kodak and Canon cameras, and they used to use a film of silver chloride and silver bromide. And when silver is a photosensitized material, when the light falls on it, image gets captured. And this is how the photography, the images get captured on the photographic film, which is essentially having the layers of silver chloride and the silver bromide. And one more example I would like to cite here is a very household example, wherein you know lemon pickle, everyone likes lemon pickle. And the lemon pickle is essentially prepared, if you look at the way your mother or you prepare the lemon pickle at home, what you do in a transparent glass bottle, you don't use any stainless steel utensil for that. You use a glass bottle, transparent glass bottle, and you put all the ingredients like your slice of lemons, then you put some lemon juice in it, then you put sugar, chili and all other ingredients, all other spices in it, and you put it in the sunlight for many days. So that is again a good example of understanding what photochemistry is. Let us move forward and try to understand how this photochemistry has evolved. So looking forward, looking backward, in 1817, the German physicist Grotthus, Theodor von Grotthus, he recognized that in order for light to be effective in producing a chemical change, it had to be absorbed. This was the first observation by Grotthus. And this was supported by Draper in the year 1841, when he tried the reaction between hydrogen and the chlorine gas and irradiated with the light. And this was recognized as the first photochemical reaction. And after the initiation of the reaction, he noticed that, because as a scientist, you need to be very, very vigilant. And the Draper was equally vigilant, and his observation has led to what is referred as photochemistry nowadays. So what he observed, that when you increase the intensity of the light, the rate of the reaction increases. To understand what is intensity, because I know many of my friends cannot understand what is intensity. Intensity is essentially number of photons per second. So let us say this is a surface, my palm is a surface, and if a light falling on it, and if the light, you know that light has a different color based on its wavelength. If the color of the light changes, means wavelength is changing. And intensity means the number of photons of that wavelength reaching the particular surface. So let us say that if 10 photons are colliding with the surface, then the intensity would be 10. 10 photons per second are colliding, then it will be intensity would be 10. On the contrary, if 100 photons are colliding with the surface per second, then the intensity would be 100. So you can understand that intensity refers to the number of photons per second. Okay, so and these two observation has led to the first law of photochemistry, and that is referred as Grotthus and Draper law. We'll see this law in more detail and as we proceed further, but it will not be covered in the today's lecture. Today we will try to understand what are photochemical and thermal reaction. Rather, we will try to differentiate between the thermal and the photochemical reaction. Now, when it comes to the reaction, you know that all reaction involve breaking and making of the bond. Now, the path that it follows will be the difference between the thermal and the photochemical reaction. If a path followed is such that it involves the absorption or emission of heat, then it can be a thermal reaction. If the reaction involves absorption of light or emission of light, then it could be a photochemical reaction. So essentially, thermal reactions are caused wherein the bond breaking and bond making is because of what? Because of the heat energy. Whereas in photochemical reaction, bond breaking and making is because of the absorption of light. And if you see any reaction, you will notice that you will try to focus on the bond breaking and bond making. Now, there are many steps in the reaction. How do reaction initiate? What are the conditions in which it takes place? What are the thermodynamic conditions? What is the mechanistic pathway? What about the kinetics? What about the effect of temperature on the reactions? If you try to answer these questions, I will repeat once again. In the chemical reaction, what we offer, what we look at? We look at how the reaction is initiated, number one. What is a impetus for the reaction? What about the thermodynamics? Thermodynamics means change in entropy, change in enthalpy, change in free energy. Then what about the mechanism? What about the mechanistic pathway it follow? Then what about the kinetics, whether it is fast or slow? And next is, what is the effect of certain parameter, especially the temperature on the reaction? If you try to answer these seven questions, you will get the 7 point of differences between the thermal and the photochemical reaction. Let us see it one by one. So these reactions involve, thermal reactions involve the absorption of light, absorption or emission of light, whereas photochemical reaction involves the absorption or emission of light. Thermal reactions involve the absorption or emission of heat, whereas photochemical reaction involves the absorption or emission of light. These are initiated by the collision between the reactant molecule. We all know that when we increase the temperature, the molecule undergo a sort of a motion. And when they undergo motion, we call them as a Brownian motion. And when they collide with each other, it leads to the energy of activation. And when the energy of activation is reached, they cross that energy of activation barrier and lead to the product formation. The same thing happens with the photochemical reaction, but here the excitation of the molecule is not because of the collision between the molecule, but it is because of the absorption of light. Thermal reaction can take place in dark, whereas presence of light is a primary requirement. If no light, no reaction will take place. Free energy change for this reaction is always negative. In terms of thermodynamics, we say that the process is spontaneous only if the change in the free energy is negative. On the contrary, for photochemical reaction, this condition is not true. It may or may not be negative. Sometimes it may be positive, but the photochemical reaction will take place. Thermal reactions are simple in nature, whereas photochemical reactions are complex in nature. Simple in the sense that, let us say one example, say ethyl bromide reacting with aqueous NaOH. So you take ethyl bromide in a test tube, you add NaOH to it, you stir it, and you get ethyl alcohol. So the mechanism, if you try to study, either it will follow SN1 or SN2 pathway. You all are aware of that. In that pathway, you will see that bond breaking will take place sequentially and it will lead to the product formation. Whereas in photochemical reaction, they are complex in nature because essentially it involves two steps. Number one is absorption of light and then excitation of the reactant molecule. Then number two is that excited molecule may lead to the formation of product, or it may undergo some other phenomena which may not lead to the product. So sometimes it leads to the chain reaction. And that is why they are referred as complex in nature. And thermal reactions are usually fast, whereas photochemical reactions are generally slow. And the rate of the thermal reaction, it depends upon the temperature, whereas rate of the photochemical reaction is independent of the temperature. It is said that about the thermal reaction, if you increase the reaction temperature by 10 degrees, the reaction rate will double. But the same rule will not be followed for the photochemical reaction. So with these, I will stop for today's lecture. And in the next video, I will be covering the laws of photochemistry. Thank you for your attention. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.